हेलो एवरीवन, हाय, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर विलास अनिल चव्हाण, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फॉरेंसिक साइंस, पारुल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ अप्लाइड साइंसेस, पारुल यूनिवर्सिटी, वडोदरा, गुजरात. वेलकम टू ई लर्निंग. सो टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वील बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द पेपर टाइटल्ड क्वेश्चन डॉक्यूमेंट एंड द नंबर ऑफ पेपर इज 1117254. So today we'll be discussing about the chapter 2, and under this chapter you will be introduced to the different crimes which are related to document, then essentials to produce documents and different types of documents. So this is the content of chapter number 2. Now let's discuss the learning outcomes. So after studying this chapter, students shall be able to know more about the crimes which are related to documents. Also, they shall be able to understand about the different essentials which are required for the production of any document. And along with this, after studying this chapter, students shall also be able to classify the documents based on various characteristics. So these are the learning outcomes of this chapter. Now let's start with the crimes which are related to document. So below are different crimes which are listed here. So apart from these all crimes, there are some other crimes where document will be collected as the major evidences. So let's talk about the few crimes which are already listed here. So first is the white collar crime. So white collar crime is a non-violent crime where the primary motive is typically financial in nature. White collar criminals usually occupy a professional position of power or prestige, and one that commands well above average compensation. So that is the white collar crime. Typical white collar crimes could include wage theft, fraud, bribery, then Ponzi schemes, insider trading, labor racketeering, embezzlement, cybercrime, copyright infringement, money laundering, identity theft, and forgery. So this white collar crime overlaps with the corporate crime. Now let's discuss what is the black collar crime. So black collar crime is an action or omission committed by a religious or judicial figure that constitutes an offense that may be prosecuted by the state and is punishable by law, and that priest is guilty of child molestation, which is a black collar crime. Then what is the red collar crime? So red collar crime is a subgroup of white collar crime in which the perpetrator uses violence to avoid detection or prosecutions. And then what is green collar crime? So here the green collar crime is a crime committed against nature. This term can refer to actual crime in the sense that the act is illegal by the country's law, or more crime that may not be illegal. So here only the important type of crime to us is the white collar crime, which may include different types of crimes ranging from insider trading, then the labor racketeering, embezzlement, copyright infringement, and money laundering, etc. The next is the forgery. So forgery is a serious type of crime where imitation or the copying of any genuine article will be done for different purposes. So forgery can be defined as the crime of illegally copying a document सिग्नेचर पेंटिंग एक्सेट्रा, दैट इज द फॉर्जरी. एंड देर मे बी अ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फॉर्जरीज ऑल्सो विच मे इंक्लूड आर्कियोलॉजिकल फॉर्जरी, देन आर्ट फॉर्जरी, देन ब्लैक प्रोपागंडा, दैट इज फॉल्स इंफॉर्मेशन एंड मटेरियल दैट परपोर्ट्स टू बी फ्रॉम अ सोर्स ऑन वन साइड ऑफ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बट इज एक्चुअली फ्रॉम द अपोजिट साइड, दैट इज द ब्लैक प्रोपागंडा. देन काउंटरफिटिंग, काउंटरफिटिंग ऑफ करेंसी, काउंटरफिटिंग ऑफ coin, then the production of false document, and the forgery is a covert operation. The next is the business crime. It may be any crime which is directly or indirectly related to any type of business. Then abduction for money. This is also a serious crime where one can find the document as the major evidences. Then the arson. So arson is again an important type of crime. So you must understand the difference between arson and fire. So fire is act where something will be burned. It may be an accidental act, but here arson is one type of fire only, but if that act contains any criminal intention behind the setting of fire, then that act can be called as the arson. So arson can also be defined as the crime of setting fire to a building on purpose, or sometimes a crime at common law originally defined as the malicious burning of the dwelling of another. Depending upon the jurisdiction, the intentional setting of a fire to a building, or else the international or intentional setting of a fire to a building where people live, that is the arson. So arson can be done for various purposes. For example, crime concealment. So it is an attempt to conceal another type of crime such as murder, burglary, or an attempt to destroy documents or records by the fire. Now consider if someone has set fire to the document, then in that case you'll be able to find the charred document, or sometimes it can be called as a burnt document. So here the role of investigating officer is to collect those documents very carefully, and later on preservation has to be done, and later on information has to be extracted. So that is the arson case where document can be collected as the major evidences. The next is the cheating. So cheating is one type of fraud where a people or a group of people may cheat any other party, any other persons for financial gain. So cheating can also be defined as the to trick somebody, especially when that person trusts you to deceive somebody, or to act in an dishonest or unfair way in order to get an advantage for yourself. That is the cheating. Also, cheating is to be emotionally or physically unfaithful. There are degrees of cheating, from sexual betrayal of a partner or a spouse to affairs of the heart in which a member of relationship has a secret, emotionally meaningful relations outside his or her primary one. So in this type of crime also, there are chances that one can find the document as major evidences. The next is the suicide. Suicide is the killing ourselves. So where there are chances that you will find the suicide note, and by simply collecting the suicide note, the one who is investigating the case, that person may get the information behind the suicide of a particular person. Even इन सुसाइड केस एग्जामिनेशन इफ यू हैव फाउंड एनी सुसाइडल नोट्स देन सिंपली बाय एनालाइजिंग द राइटिंग व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट ओवर देयर वन शैल बी एबल टू डिटरमाइन वेदर दिस राइटिंग बिलोंग्स टू द डेड पर्सन और नॉट एंड बाय डिटरमाइनिंग द ऑथरशिप ऑफ राइटिंग वन मे डिटरमाइन दैट वेदर द केसेस ऑफ सुसाइड और होमिसाइड सो दैट कैन बी अचीव्ड बाय सिंपली एनालाइजिंग द राइटिंग व्हिच इज रिटन ओवर देयर ऑन द सुसाइड नोट द नेक्स्ट इज द डॉक्यूमेंट फॉर्जरी सो अगेन दैट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट टाइप ऑफ क्राइम सो फॉर्जरी इम्प्लाइज फॉल्स डॉक्यूमेंट सिग्नेचर्स और अदर इमिटेशंस ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ यूटिलिटी यूज्ड विद द इंटेंट टू डिसीव अनादर दोज हु कमिट फॉर्जरी आर यूजुअली चार्ज विद द क्राइम ऑफ फ्रॉड ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ द फॉर्जरी इंक्लूड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स आइडेंटिफिकेशन कार्ड एंड लीगल सर्टिफिकेट्स सो इज फॉर्जिंग डॉक्यूमेंट्स अ क्राइम यस इट इज अ क्राइम सो फॉर्जरी इज अ क्राइम व्हेन द पर्सन नोविंगली क्रिएट्स और पजेसेस फॉल्स डॉक्यूमेंट्स सच एज मनी पोस्टेज स्टैम्प्स मिलिट्री डॉक्यूमेंट्स लेटर्स पैटेंट मनी ऑर्डर्स और अदर गवर्नमेंट रिलेटेड इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स सो अगेन एज आई सेड इनिशियली डॉक्यूमेंट फॉर्जरी इज अ सीरियस क्राइम एंड इन दैट केस देर आर चांसेस ऑफ गेटिंग द डॉक्यूमेंट्स एज अ इम्पोर्टेंट एविडेंस विच कैन प्रूव दैट द क्राइम हैज टेकन प्लेस सो हियर फॉर्जरी इज डिफाइंड अंडर द सेक्शन 463 ऑफ इंडियन पिनल कोड So that's all about the crimes which are related to documents. Now let's discuss about the essentials which are required to produce the document. So below are the common materials. So in order to produce any kind of documents, you must have three major materials. First is writing surface, then you must have writing tool. And you must have writing material. So, as you know, the definition of document is anything which is written on any surface. So, here comes the writing surface. So, it may be a paper, it may be a slate, it may be a board, it may be a wall also. So, here document is anything written on any surface in the form of letter, figure by using any writing tool. It may be a pen or pencil, right? Which will be including any special kind of writing material. For example, ink, graphite or chalk. So these are the writing materials. So by using which, if something has been written on any surface and which conveys the meaningful message, then as that article can be called as the document. So here what we require in order to produce document are writing surfaces just like paper, slate, board, then the writing tools just like pen, pencil and beside that a typewriter or a photocopying machine or a printer. These are also a writing tools and as far as writing materials are concerned So that is ink, graphite or a chalk. So these are the common materials which we should have in order to produce the document. Now let's discuss about the classification or types of document. So for the purpose of discussions, the important documents which affect our day-to-day lives may be classified into following categories. So first category of document or first classification of document is civil documents. So civil documents may include different types of documents such as birth registration certificate, death certificate, marriage registration certificate or divorce certificate. So these all documents falls under the category of civil document. Then the next classification of document is routine documents, or we can simply call it as a daily used document, which may be a ID card of any company or any educational institute or any research institute, then the voter ID card, then PAN card, Aadhaar card, then domicile certificate, then the caste certificate, BPL certificate, ration card, examination mark sheets, examination degrees, examination certificates, testimonials, motor vehicle registration certificate and driving license. So these all documents falls under the routine type of document. Then the next type of document is travel document. So this travel document may include passport, visa, nationality certificate, resident aligned card, permanent resident card, naturalization and citizenship certificate. So these all documents falls under the travel document. The next category is bank documents. So simply any document which is directly or indirectly linked to the bank agencies, so which may include check, drafts, traveler check, currency note, credit card, debit card and smart card. So this type of all the documents falls under the category of bank document. The next classification is security documents executed on stamp paper. So here stamp paper is the one type of security documents, and here a security documents can be defined as a document which is more secured by means of introducing different types of security features at different level, that is the security document. So which may include DP note, then hypothecations or bank guarantee, agreement, property transfer or property registrations. Then the next classification is judicial documents. So this type of document may include important court orders, judgments, laboratory reports or summons. So this all falls under the judicial documents. The next classification is commerce related document, which may include patents and copyright certifications and logo. And next classification is paperless or digital documents. So this type of category may include electronic money transfers through websites, online transactions and e-banking solutions. So that's all about the classification of document. So thank you all. Have a good day.